Assalamualaikum. I welcome you all for class 7 subject science. So today we are going to continue with our topic, that is electric current and its effect. So now here we are going to learn about heating effect of electric current. Okay. For that, take an electric cell, a bulb and a switch and connect wires. As you can see here in the figure, a bulb, a battery and the wires, you can do it. Then this activity has to be done using only the cell. Keep the switch in on and off position. Does the bulb glow? You should not try it with the electric circuits at all. You should just do it with the battery or the cell there. Okay? Because the power of the current will differ. Okay? Don't take a wire and put it in the electric switches at home. You should use a cell, the small cell which we use in the remotes or in the what toys, that we have to use and check. And this is not the big bulb. This, instead of this, you should take a small bulb, that LED bulb which will be there in your toys, that you can try it. Not with the big bulb and the electric switches at home. It is very dangerous. Now what's happening here means, what happened? Now the bulb is blown. Just you on for some time, okay? First you touch and you on. Before oning the bulb, touch the bulb. What happens? It will be cool, right? After that, you on for some time. On it for at least 15 minutes, 10 minutes. Then you off it. Then touch the bulb once again. What can you feel? You can feel the bulb has become hot. Yes or no? Yes, once you touch it, it will become hot. You are not able to touch the bulb. The filament that is inside the bulb, it will be hot. This shows that the heat will, the electricity produces heat also. That is, when the electric current passes through any object, the object will get heated up. Okay, the object will get heated up. Now what about the wire? Wire is not getting heated. Why? Because the wire is covered. Okay, that is inside there is copper where the current is passing. But on the copper we have the covering surface, that is the plastic or you can say the rubber there, which does not allow the current to pass. Therefore the wire will not get heated up. Only the bulb will get heated. Clear? So now which are the heating appliances that we can see at home? So you can see here, that is the electric oven and then electric toaster. Then this is the electric heater which is used. Right. The wire gets hot when an electric current passes through it. This is the heating effect of the electric current. You might have seen an electric room heater or an electric heater used for cooking. This you have seen at home, right? This is the electric stove where this wire will get heated and then the cooking will take place. Now what is there inside? So as I said, the filament. Filament is nothing but the wire which is passed. All this contains a coil of wire. This coil of wire is called an element. Okay, what it is called? Element. Here this wire, this is nothing but the wire, but it is in a coil form. This coil form gets heated up very fast. Therefore, this part is known as an element. You may have noticed that when appliances are switched on, after connecting to the electric supply, their elements become red and hot and give out heat, as you can see here in the stove. The amount of heat produced in the wire depends on its material, length and thickness. Means how much it will be heated, how much it will not. Some will heat fast, some will heat less. Yes or no? Why? Because again it depends on the material. What kind of wire is used, how much length is used and how much thickness is used. Based on that, the heatness depend. Okay. Thus, for different requirements, the wire of different materials and different lengths and thickness are used. The wire used for making electric circuits do not normally become hot. Okay. For the wires, as I said you, it will not become hot because the material which is used, it should not get hotted. On the other hand, the elements of some electric appliances become so hot that they are easily visible, which we can see here. In few appliances we are not able to see the element, okay? For example, in the iron, right? In the electric iron, which we use for what? Ironing the clothes. See here, inside it there is a coil of wires. This is known as the element, where this part will get heated up, then your iron will get then your clothes will get pressed, okay? And again, similarly, even in the bulb, here you can see in the bulb, this is the element, okay? This is the element is in the bulb. It is known as filament. What it is known as? Filament. This thin wire is known as the filament in the bulb. In the other electric appliances, it is known as element. In the bulb especially, it is known as filament. This filament start where the electricity will pass, and this will get heated up. Because of this, the bulb starts glowing. Incandescent electric bulbs are often used for lighting, but they also give heat. It means that a part of electricity consumed is used in producing heat. This is not desirable as it result in the wastage of electricity. Now, for example, here there are four types of bulbs. You can see, right? You can see the LED bulb also, fluorescent bulb, and incandescent bulb. What happens? We need only the light. We don't want heat. Yes or no? We are using the electricity for producing light. But what's happening here is, with the light, the heat is also produced. Means our electricity is getting wasted. Yes or no? Total amount of electricity is not used in the form of light. A few percent is wasted in the form of heat. Nowadays, instead of fluorescent bulb lamps and the incandescent bulbs, we are using LED bulbs. What is the full form of LED? LED is light emitting diode, which you can see here. This part we are using, right? We have stopped using this, right? This we were using before. Now we are using this. Why? Because this will not emit heat. Okay, light emitting diode. Only it will give more light. Instead of fluorescent lamps, we are using LED light emitting diode bulbs. Is increasing for producing a given intensity of light. LED bulbs consume less electricity as compared to incandescent bulbs and fluorescent tubes. These are the fluorescent tubes, okay, or CFL we will say. Thus, LED bulbs are much electricity efficient, and therefore being preferred. And one more thing you have to remember, before taking any bulb, we have to check for the ISI mark. This is the ISI mark, means Indian standard, okay. So what it means is, it is advised to use electrical appliances and gadgets which are electricity efficient, means where the electricity is not wasted and which is not harmful. Bureau of Indian Standard, New Delhi, assigned a standard mark on the products called ISI mark, which is an assurance of conformity to the specification given on the products. It is therefore suggested to use ISI mark products only. Fluorescent tubes and CFL contains mercury. What happens here? Why this fluorescent tube and this CFL is wasting the electricity? Means the fluorescent tubes and CFL contain mercury vapor, toxic in nature. They are not only wasting the electricity, but they are toxic in nature. Therefore, damaged fluorescent tubes or CFL need to be disposed of safely. It is dangerous when it stops. No, you should not play with that. You should not break at home. You should just throw it away. Why? Because it contains mercury in it, which is toxic in nature.